فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، واشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، واشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى this is going to be the fourth part بإذن الله الكريم. And we will be taking the last two mas'ala, the last two issues pertaining to the topic that we were speaking about, which is Zakatul Fitr Masailu wa Ahkamun. In this sit, inshallah ta'ala, we will be speaking about Miqdarul Mukhraji min Zakatul Fitr wa Hukmu Ikhrajihi bil Qima. This topic, inshallah ta'ala, we will be speaking about two things. In this point, we're going to be speaking about two things. The first thing that we're going to be speaking about, inshallah ta'ala, is the amount that is given out in Zakatul Fitr and its types. مِقْدَارُ الْمُخْرَجِ مِنْ زَكَاتِ الْفِطْرِ وَنَوْعَهُ and its types. We'll speak about that. And the second, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to be speaking about is إِخْرَاجُ زَكَاتُ الْفِطْرِ بِالْقِيمَةِ is giving zakat al-fitr based on value. In other words, giving it in money other than food. So those is what we're going to be speaking about in the mas'ala al-rabi'ah, the fourth issue or the fourth matter. And in the fifth, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be speaking about في مصرف زكاة الفطر, meaning who the zakat al-fitr is given to, who are the people who are entitled to take the zakat al-fitr, whose is it, who is it distributed to, and that's the fifth one we're going to be speaking about in the fifth mas'ala بإذن الله الكريم. Now let's start inshallah ta'ala with the first one, which is مقدار المخرج من زكاة الفطر, the amount that is given in the zakat al-fitr and its type. Now there are opinions pertaining to this issue. There are views pertaining to this issue, meaning there are different views that different scholars hold. عند الحنفية, according to the Hanafis, the miqdar which is wajib, the amount that is wajib in zakat al-fitr is نصف صاع من بر that half of صاع of a بر half of a صاع of a بر and the amount that a صاع is, it is 3 liters. 3 liters. 0.75 liters times that by 4. 3, right? And then one mud is 0.75. And a sa' is how many mud? It's 4 mud. It's 4 mud, which is 0.75 liters. And then the measurement of one sa' is 3 liters. Correct? The Hanafis believe that the bur is not one sa'. So how much is going to be in liters? 3 is, half of us, 3 is what? 1.5. So then 1.5 liters in bur is what they believe. And bur is wheat. The bur is wheat. Or sa' min, or one sa', which is 3 liters. Min sha'irin, sha'ir is barley. Last time I said wheat, but it's incorrect. It is barley. Or sa' min tamrin. Or a sa' of a tamar. Then pay attention to this. Three things are all the same. You have to underline this and remember this. The bur and the hinta and the qamh. These three are all wheat in the Arabic language. Bur, hinta, and al-qamh. They're just different stages within the wheat. Abu Bakr, you know wheat, right? Wheatabix. The next, that is what? That is nusf sa' min burrin. And then according to the Hanafis, the wheat is not a full sa'. It's not 3 liters. It is how much? Half. Very good. And then the second one for them is what? The sha'ir. The sha'ir is how much? Sha'ir is barley. For them it's a full sa'. So 3 liters. And the tamr, the dates. For them it's what? It's a full sa', 3 liters. What have we just learned from there? What we've learned from there is, the Hanafis, they have usulan لغيرها من الأجناس الأخرى. These are the three usul to the Hanafis, three usul. Every other food, they believe تقوم ثم بقيمة المقوم منها يشترى الجنس المراد إخراجه. If you want to give rice, they're going to weigh it according to those three. Does that make sense? Sorry, the value of it. So once they get the hinta is what? It's like the bur, because it's a wheat. So there's half of a sa'. Whatever value and amount it becomes, the price that it becomes, the rice has to be that price, not that measurement. Price. The barley, which is the sha'ir, it's one sa'. They say, they weigh it with that, one of those threes. With tafasil connected to it. Where is the evidence for that? The evidence that they use is the hadith. And the funny thing, subhanAllah, is that, and one has to be very careful, wallahi, is that, you know, Sunnah online, when they brought this particular hadith, straight after that, they gave it hukm al-da'f. They said the hadith is weak, graded by Sheikh al-Albani. Then I was amazed because I remember Sheikh Nasir authenticating this hadith. Then I went to Sheikh al-Albani, rahimahullah, his taqreej that he done on the Mishkat al-Masabih. And then I went to his tasheeh in the Sunnah Abi Dawood. And the hadith, which is in Sunnah Abi Dawood, is not weak to Al-Albani in all of it. The hadith is of two segments, it's two shatr. The first segment is sahih to Al-Albani, but the second part is, and the second ziyadah is what is weakened by him. And then when you go to these websites, you don't see the grading correctly done. Does that make sense? Very important, let alone the translation that is incorrect. So the hadith, the first shatr, the first part, which is sa'un min burrin, أو قمح على كل اثنين صغير أو كبير حر أو عبد ذكر أو أنثى. That part of the hadith is صحيح, which is one sa' of bur and قمح, which are both wheat. على كل اثنين صغير أو كبير, to the elderly person or the young. So two. So what does that mean? Bur or qamh ala kulli thnainin. So a person gives one sa' of a bur, are you with me? To two people, what does that mean? Each person is getting how much? Half. So for them, the bur, are you with me? And the qamh, which both are what? They're both wheat. They believe it's what? Half. Half a sa' based on the hadith. Good. And of course the hadith of ثعلبة بن سعير رضي الله تعالى عنه وإذ قام فينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطيبا فأمر بصدقة الفطر صاع تمر أو صاع شعير عن كل رأس. And then the hadith has a ziyada which says أو صاع بر أو قمح بين اثنين. So they said that the شعير and the تمر, the شعير and the تمر, the hadith of ثعلبة بن الصعير clearly says what? صاع تمر أو صاع شعير عن كل رأس, every individual. But then when he came to the qamh and the burr, he said, "Bayn athnayni, between two." So they said for them, the wheat is half a sa'. Are you with me? And half a sa', and the sha'ir and the tamar, it's a sa', a full sa'. Is that crystal clear? Is that well understood? Very important that we understand it. The second opinion now. أما المقدار الواجب في زكاة الفطر عند الجمهور. This is according to the who? The majority. This is the second opinion. من المالكية والشافعية والحنابلة. This is the second opinion regarding the مقدار الواجب في زكاة الفطر. The amount that is obligatory in the زكاة الفطر. This is the view of the جمهور. Is from the Malikiyya and the Shafi'iyya and the Hanabila. Is فَوَصَاعٌ عَنْ كُلِّ فَرْدٍ مِنْ جَمِيعِ الْأَجْنَاسِ الْمُخْرَجِ مِنْهَا. They believe there's no such a thing as half a burr. Sorry, half a sa' in the burr, in the wheat. They believe it is all sa' on every individual. On every type of the food that's been given, all of it has to be what? Sa'. And they said anything that's considered as to be food. Are you with me? That is sa'. And the hadith they relied on is amalan bi hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. Based on the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Where Abi Sa'id al-Khudri said, kunna nukhriju idh kana fina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam zakat al-fitri an kulli saghirin wa kabirin hurrin aw mamlukin sa'an min ta'amin aw sa'an min aqatin أو صاع من شعير أو صاع من تمر أو صاع من زبيب فلم نزل نخرجه حتى قدم علينا معاوية بن أبي سفيان حاجا أو معتمرا فكلم الناس على المنبر فكان فيما كلم به الناس أن قال إني أرى أن مدين من سمراء الشام تعدل صاع من تمر فأخذ الناس بذلك. قال أبو سعيد الخدري فأما أنا فلا أزال أخرجه كما كنت أخرجه أبدا ما عشته. This hadith, Abi Sa'id al-Khudri said at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Prophet was amongst us, so this hadith takes what? حكم الرفعي. It's a hadith attributed to the Prophet. I mean, this is what we used to do at the time of the Prophet. زكاة الفطر, we used to give out the زكاة الفطر عن كل صغير وكبير, whether it's a child that is young or whether it's an elderly person. Whether it's a free individual or whether it's a slave, it doesn't matter. Unrestricted, all of them. صَاعًا مِنْ طَعَامٍ. Pay attention. صَاعًا مِنْ طَعَامٍ. صَاع, food. أو صَاعًا مِنْ أَقَطٍ. Or a صَاع of cheese or dried yogurt, whichever translation you go for. أو صَاعًا مِنْ شَعِيرٍ. Or a صَاع. And we said صَاع is 3 liters. Of sha'ir bali, aw sa'an min tamrin, or one sa', 3 liters of dates, aw sa'an min zabibin, or one sa' of raisins. فَلَمْ نَزَلْ نُخْرِجُ حَتَّى قَدِمَ عَلَيْنَا مُعَاوِيَةَ. The time of the Prophet, we never used to give it out except like that. This is how we used to do it. Until Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan came to us. And then Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, he came to us. Hajjan, either he was doing Hajj or Umrah. He spoke to the people on the pulpit. And then he said to them, فَكَانَ فِي مَا كَلَّمَ بِهِ النَّاسِ. He started to speak to the people. And then he said, I see, أَنَا أَرَى. My opinion is, that أَنَّ مُدَّيْنِ. How many muds did we say that the sa' is? Four. 0.75. That's how much it was, right? Three liters now, صح? Muawiyah came and he said, the Samra al-Sham, I believe, he says that we've seen, I see, that it's what? Two moods of the sa' of the dates that you guys have. So the Sabra' Sham that we have in Sham, that we use, is two moods of the sa' that you guys have in dates. And then how much is the sa' of the dates? Four mud. So he's saying it's half of it. Half of it. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, so the people took the opinion of Muawiyah and it was taken on board. Now, Muawiyah was a faqih, as Abdullah ibn Abbas said about him. Faqih. But Abu Sa'id al-Khudri said, look, fa'ama ana, as for me, fa'la azalu ukhrijuhu. I'm not going to stop. For anyone. I'm going to remain giving out kama kuntu ukhrijuhu, the way I used to give it out, abadan ma'ishtu, as long as I live. As long as I'm alive, I will give it out how I used to give it at the time of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then from this hadith, the thing that's given out there, according to the Malikiyya and the Shafi'iyya, is based upon ghalibu qutu ahlil balad. That they took from this hadith and the likes of this hadith another fiqh, which is what? That you're coming to a people who don't eat, for example, barley. They don't eat barley. And you're giving them that as a sadaqah. They said, no. This hadith shows that you give what the people of that land are, they use regularly. So the thing that's eaten, the majority of the food that's eaten, this is what should be given to the people of that land. This is what they said. This is the view of the Malikiyya and the Shafi'iyya. This is the opinion that they took. بينما الحنابلة, as for the حنابلة, they took the view which is whoa, no. أن الواجب التعيّن. No, you have no choice, brother. All that which the Prophet mentioned from the foods that he mentions, you specifically have to sit with those. You can only choose from the hinda, the sha'ir, the tamr, and the aqatin, and the zabib. Those are the things that were mentioned. The Prophet specifically narrowed it down to those five that we mentioned. Al-hintat, wal-sha'ir, wal-tamr, wal-aqatu, and the zabib. this is what's happened. What caused the khilaf then? And what's the sabab ukhtilafihim? What is the sabab and the reason why they differed on this issue? The khilaf is mafhumu hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. It is based upon this hadith that we just took right now, the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Some of them they took from this hadith, and this is the view that was taken by the Malikiyya and the Shafi'iyya, which is at-takhyiru bayna al-ansaf al-madhkurati fi al-hadithi. That this hadith mentions optional, that you have the choice. Because look what it says. أو صاع من أقط أو صاع من شعير أو صاع من تمر أو صاع من زبيب. You have the choice. تنويع. The hadith is giving you optional, whichever one you give. So they said, because there is تخيير, there's choice in the hadith, they said that the person has a choice to choose what food he wants to give. Any type of food he gives out. And some, which is the view of the Hanabila, is the hadith is not at-takhyir wal-ibaha, that choice that you have. No, the first opinion, sorry, take that back. The first choice, the first from fahm is the fahm of the Hanabila, which is you've been given tanwi' within those which were mentioned. Within those that were mentioned. Such as, you have given, the first type of people, they said, فَمَنْ فَهِمَ مِنْهُ التَّخِيرُ بَيْنَ أَصْنَافٍ الْمَذْكُورَةِ فِي الْحَدِيثِ. There's the first, the khilaf of the hadith has come because some have understood it to mean that you have a choice between the aforementioned food. So the hadith clearly states, زَكَاتُ الْفِطْرِ, that that you can give sa'an min taqatin, or sa'an min sha'irin, or sa'an min tamrin, or sa'an min zabibin. Of choice. So because it gave you those choices, then nothing else can be given. That's one view. The other opinion they took from the hadith, which is the fahm of the Shafi'iyah and the Malikiyah, is that what they took from the hadith is that the hadith showed that any land whose food is this, is very common in their lands, this food, or the people whose food, this is common in it. So for example, some people might be common in their lands, sha'ir. Some people in their lands, no, tamar is very common. And some people in their lands, zabib is very common. Huh? Then in this situation, they're allowed to do whichever of those is very common in their land. And said, because that's the wisdom behind it, then it doesn't restrict it to them. The hikmah, the wisdom, it revolves around here, غَالِبُ الْقُوتِ الْبَلَدِ. It revolves around what is very common that's eaten in the... And the Sharia can't mention every food on the face of this earth. So it gave you عَلَى سَبِيلِ التَّمْثِيلِ لَلْحَصَرِ. That this is just an example. It's a framework, but it doesn't restrict it just to these types. It means you're free to do anything other than that. Now we're going to move on to the next part of the fourth mas'ala, which is إخراج زكاة الفطر بالقيمة. Giving the زكاة الفطر with قيمة, which is value. This is the issue, which is, can money be put in place instead of food? This is another issue. If the sa' of the tamar is worth this much in money, can I just give what it's worth and just give the money instead of the food? Can I do that? As for giving the zakat al-fitr based upon value, on the value that it is, فَقَدْ مَنَعَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ الْجُمْهُورِ. The majority of the scholars, they reject that and they refuse that. مِنَ الشَّافِعِيَّةِ وَالْمَالِكِيَّةِ وَالْحَنَابِلَةِ. They don't accept that. As Imam al-Nawawi رحمه الله said, وَلَمْ يُجِزْ عَامَّةُ الْفُقَهَا وَلَمْ يُجِزْ عَامَّةُ الْفُقَهَاءِ إِخْرَاجَ الْقِيمَةِ وَأَجَازَهُ أَبُو حَنِيفَةِ. The majority of the scholars, they do not permit to give the value of the zakat al-fitr, but Abu Hanifa permitted it. And Abu Hanifa rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah, he values, and also the Hanafi madhab, ikhraj al-qimati min al-nuqud. They prefer more money. But the value here is done with money in zakat al-fitr. Then what? عَلَىٰ إِخْرَاجِ الْعَيْنِ. Then giving that particular amount, or that particular food that was mentioned, they prefer that people give money. And what was their reason for that? وَعَلَّلُوا ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ الْمَقْصُودَ مِنْ أَدَاءِ زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ إِغْنَاءُ الْفَقِيرِ الَّذِي يَتَحَقَّقُ غِنَاهُ بِالْعَيْنِ أَوْ بِالْقِيمَةِ. They said that because they said the objective and the aim is to enrich the poor and to suffice him in what he needs. And so they said, giving it by money is anfa'u lil faqir, is more befitting and more enriching for the poor. Because then he can use it for whatever he wishes and what he wants. You've not restricted him, but he might need clothing, he might need something else. Give him the money. They believe. As for the madhab al-jumhur, the majority of the scholars, فَقَدْ عَلَلُوا مَنْعَ إِخْرَاجِ الْقِيمَةِ فِي زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ بِوُرُودِ النَّصِ فِي الطَّعَامِ دُونَ التَّعَرُّضِ لِلْقِيمَةِ. The second are the view of the madhab al-jumhur. It is the opinion of the majority of the scholars. They said that it is not permissible to give out by qima, by the amount and the value, fi zakat al-fitr, in zakat al-fitr, because they said a textual evidence has occurred in what? In food. and it did not mention value. فَلَوْ جَازَتْ And if it was permissible to give it by value, لَبَيَّنَهَا النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Prophet would have clarified it. Are you with me? عليه الصلاة والسلام. مَعَنَّ التَّعَامُلُ بِالنُّقُودِ Even that though giving it out with money, كَانَ قَائِمًا وَالْحَاجَةُ تَدْعُوا إِلَيْهَا The need was always there. For the fuqara, whatever you guys are saying, at the time of the Prophet, that need was there. Are you there? And the money at the time of the Prophet was also there. And the fact that the Prophet ﷺ didn't clarify that and did not say the permissibility of it, this shows us the qa'idah which is well known. تَأْخِيرَ الْبَيَانِ عَنْ وَقْتِ الْحَاجَةِ لَا يَجُوزُ This qa'idah is what? Delaying clarification when the time of need is there is not permissible. Meaning the Prophet will never delay something that needs to be clarified at the time it was required to be clarified. For the Prophet to delay it, this is something that will never happen. It can't happen. Because his job was to clarify things. Alayhi salatu wassalam. And also they said, their argument still going on. If you guys, those who said that money is what the rich needs, then the scholars they said, How would you know that this poor needs the money? Because you as an individual are not giving it to a particular individual. It is not a right that a particular person owns. It's a right of a masakeen. Does that make sense? And because it's not a particular fard, I mean afarad, and it's more of a jins, it's a whole group of people. And it can go to anybody, that food that you've given. It can go to any miskeen. Then there is no taradi. He's not even pleased with it, maybe. Maybe he wanted the food. And the zakat, there's no owner of it. So for you to say that he needs the money, there's no malik that owns it. It can be taken to anybody, and it can be given to anybody. And then brothers, khulasa, the summary of this, if you look at both parties, if you now look at it from a structured, usuli angle, and this is very important, that you narrow the khilaf to the asal in which they're differing on. What's sparking this khilaf? Does it make sense? The spark of this khilaf, my brothers, it revolves around. So this dispute here, first of all, what is it? Some people are saying, ikhraju bil qeemah, giving it out with value. And the other group are saying, la al-ikhraju bil ayn, giving it out by the particular ta'am, that which was mentioned in the nusus al-shar'iyyah. Stick to those and don't go outside that. Or within the Shafi'i and the Maliki and the Hanabila, they all agree that has to be food. I mean, they did differ amongst themselves. The Hanabila did, what did they say? That these are the only ones. These are the only food. Are you with me? This is what the Hanabila said. Amma Shafi'i and Maliki, what did they say? No, it's غالب قوت البلد. It's any food that the people of the land are very commonly well known to eat. So, but it's still ta'am. The Hanaf have gone out of that and said, no, it can be qima. For what? For food. Money. It can be money. So what is the khilaf and what does it revolve around? It revolves around two mas'ala it goes under. The first one is, what is the original essence of the ahkam of the sharia? The jurisprudent rulings that are in this religion, what is the original essence of it? Is it at-ta'abbudi or is it at-ta'leel? Now this mas'ala needs to be explained. This is very important. The zakatul fitr that we're doing right now. The zakatul al-fitr. This hadith that has come regarding explaining to us that which we have to give out. Are we worshipping Allah in that weddings, ta'am, food? Or is that a illah, a reason? In simple terms, that you guys may understand better, is, and I always say this, brothers, this is lubbul fiqhi wa usuhu wa asluh. This is the original essence of fiqh. Wallahi, wabillahi wa tallahi. Any single person, any individual who masters this point that I'm speaking about now is a faqih bima'na al-kalima. Is a faqih bima'na al-kalima. Is a faqih in that word, fiqh, faqih, what it carries, all of that meaning, that's what you are. And what is it? When you learn to step over and stand and stick by the wordings, when the Sharia mentions a issue, you do not surpass the meaning, you stick by the meaning. And when you surpass the meaning, you surpass the wordings and you go over to the meaning, or the maqsad, or the illa, the reason behind it. Knowing the time, when you just stick by the meaning, you don't look at anything after that, just the wording. Allah said it, khalas. The Prophet said it, khalas. And learning when it's not just that, but it has to be gone into more to know the illa behind it, and the reasoning behind it. Does that make sense? Sometimes نحن نتوقف على اللفظ. Sometimes we just stop at the wordings. Because it's متعبت. We just have to do this. For example, we are not allowed to eat pork. Is it تعبدي or is it تعليل? It's تعبدي. There's no reason. You can't say because pork is bad for us. No illa for this brother. We worship because if you make an illa for it, then somebody can come and say, I'll remove all that illa. I'll make a pork pig in a laboratory that has none of that. More healthier than the goat that you eat. Are you going to eat it now? He removed your illa. And then the hukum was, al-hukmu yaduru ma'a illati wujudan wa adama. The ruling revolves around the reasoning. You know, we say, la. Nah, ta'abudi, this is ta'abudi. We stuck by the hadith. It stopped us, we just stick by the word. Does that make sense? Some things are ta'aleel, which is alcohol. We're prevented from drinking alcohol. We're not just going to stop by the illa is what we're going for. We're not just going to stick to khamar. We're going to move on to the illa, which is iskar, intoxication. And then if you remove this, I promise I'll drink it. If it says I make a drink in the laboratory and it doesn't intoxicate your brain, give it to me. For me, it's juice. It's called juice. It's permissible. Does that make sense? That's a simple point that you can all understand. Then knowing, ولذلك ابن القيم رحمه الله in his kitab إعلام, ابن القيم in his kitab الإعلام, this is what he stresses on, and this is what all أصول الفقه is, دلالات الألفاظ. And a tarjih, to strengthen between the opinions. I'll give you guys another example that may clarify the matter more easier for you guys. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alayhi salatu wa salam, he said to a companion who slaughtered for his child, and he was doing a feast. And so he called the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam over. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm doing a little party for my son. Can you come? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, have you done it for the rest of your children? And he said, no, Ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, no, I haven't. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I don't participate in wrongdoings. I don't participate in injustice. You're unjust by doing it. I don't participate in that stuff. Then the Prophet went on to say to the man, do you love for your children to all be obedient towards you? Do you like all of them fairly to be obedient towards you? The man said, yes, O Rasulullah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you'd be just to all of them, it's fairly then. Listen to this hadith now, pay attention. This hadith, the sahabi, was he a male or was he a female? It was a father. Can we say that this also applies for the mother? Or do we just stick by the word here? Fiqh. This is the lub. I said it's the backbone of fiqh. When do you stop at the wordings? And when can you add other people into it? We'll say that it's for both of them. Why do we say it's for both of them? Because the part where the Prophet said, do you love for both the children to be obedient? That mother and the father have that. Are you with me? Now we didn't stick by the wording. What did we do? We exactly went to the ma'ana and the meaning. Next, let's go to the next hadith. Another hadith. Another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, any individual who gives something and he takes back that which he gave is like what? Like a dog who puked and ate his puke again. Sahih? Then the Prophet ﷺ said, accept the father for his son. A father can give you and can say, give it back to me. I want it back in. Can we do this for the mother?
No.
What happened this? What's happened to this right now?
Stopped at the wedding.
Stopped at the wedding. There is nothing in the hadith that gives us the impression that it's what? That the mother also falls. It then, what? The first hadith, we didn't just stick by the wedding, we moved on to the meaning. And in the second hadith, what did we do? We stuck by the? It then here, this is the issue is, which is, now this is a question. We've now understood that the Sharia, there are times when you just stick by the weddings and you cannot move forward. And there are times when you just go over that. Now that we've understood that point, which is the asal then?
The wedding.
Which is the asal? Sticking by the wedding, not moving forward to it? Or is the asal going to the meaning and at ta'lil? This is why the khilaf occurred between the fuqaha here. Do you understand? And then remember in the room that day I put this fa'idah in there. The lub of fiqh. And the us of the fiqh. I shared it in the group. That it is learning this. And understanding that concept is very important. And then a faqih is this. Who when the nawazil and the problems occur, he deals with it correctly. Araft? Falzam. That's the first reason why it occurs. Or this is the first reason why this khilaf occurred. Number two, why the other reason it occurred, this khilaf, is because does the zakatul fitr, hal zakatul fitr tajri majra sadaqat al amwal? Does it run and does it take zakat? Does it take the ruling of what? Zakatul amwal, is it like zakatul mal? The zakat that we pay 2.5, is it the same as that one? Or is am tajri majra sadaqat al abdan kal kafarat? Or does it take the path of that which a person has to pay when he is paying for the expiation? Are you with me? The sadaqah that a person has to pay when he's doing the kafara, which is expiation, does it take that one? Or does it take the path of zakatul amwal? The person now, the group that took at-ta'lil wal-gharab. They said, no, we're looking at the objective and the reasoning behind it. In why zakatul fitr was made obligatory. Those who said, we're going to look at at-ta'lil wal-gharab, الَّذِي مِنْ أَجْلِهِ شُرِعَ زَكَاتُ الْفِطْرِ, they took that, and they also took that this zakat is zakatul amwal. They also took that zakatul amwal. And they stuck by the ta'lil, not the ta'abudi. Then this is the scholar, these are the ones who said that it can be given by qimah. These are the Hanafis. They said, we're going to take a ta'lil. The asal for us is a ta'lil. It's illa. And they also said, we take that it's zakatul amwal. Sadaqatul amwal. Are you with me?
Yeah.
My brothers now pay attention to this, and sisters who are watching. This is why I always say it's important that you don't contradict yourself. Imagine a person said, I take ta'lil as the asal, but I also take that is zakat yad tajri majra kafarat. Is that contradiction? That's contradiction. How can you take it as this and this? They do contradict each other. And then this is why you see some people that they take an opinion on something, they are upon, in their usul they're different, but then here they're just taking something else.
No.
And there's all these taraqudat that are taking place. Are you with me?
No.
You have to know why the khilaf occurred. What is the asal for each person? Where is he springing from? Where is the thought coming from? It's very important that you do that. Araft?
No.
You guys realize? It's very important. The ones who said, la, that the asal of the ahkam, وَالْمَعَانِ الشَّرْعِيَّ إِذَا التَّعَبُّدِي. No, it's ta'abudi. We're worshipping Allah on this. And والتزام ظاهر النص. And we're going to stick by the apparent wordings. And they also have to وأجراها مجرى صدقة الأبدان كالكفارات. And they took the opinion that this falls under the zakat that it's like the kafarat and والنذور والأضحية والأضحية. قالوا لا يجوز إخراج القيمة ويتعين إخراج ما ورد به النص مع مراعاة مفهومه. They're the ones who said nope, not at all. It has to be given by that which the Prophet stated, which is الطعام, food. And my brothers, what is the asl inshaAllah ta'ala mimma la shakka fihi inshaAllah ta'ala is anna shara'a idha nassa ala al-wajib. If the sharia specifically narrows down something and says it's obligatory and it specifies it, it is obligatory for you to observe that textual meaning. وَجَبَ إِلْزَامُ ظَاهِرِ النَّصِ. You have to look after that apparent meaning. And that you should take, and that it is التَّعَبُّدِ, that the أصل of the أحكام and the معاني الشرعية is التَّعَبُّدِ. It is التَّعَبُّدِ. And this is the madhab of Imam Malik and Shafi'i and Ahmad رحمهم الله. And this is also what Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah مُقَرِّرًا هَذَا. Ibn al-Qayyim said, strengthening that opinion, he said, إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ الْفِطْرِ تَجْرِي مَجْرَ كَفَّارَاتِ الْيَمِينِ تَجْرِي مَجْرَ كَفَّارَةِ الْيَمِينِ وَالظِّهَارِ وَالْقَتْلِ وَالْجِمَعِ فِي الرَّمَضَانِ وَمَجْرَ كَفَّارَةِ الْحَجِّ فَإِنَّ سَبَبَهَا هُوَ الْبَدَنُ لَيْسَ هُوَ الْمَالُ. And he took that mentioning, Shaykh al-Islam ibn al-Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, and also the view of Imam Malik, and Imam Shafi'i, and Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal. المسألة الخامسة, the fifth مسألة, في مصرف زكاة الفطر. Who are the people who are given the زكاة الفطر? اختلف الفقهاء في مصرف زكاة الفطر على قولين. The scholars, they differed upon who is the one who زكاة الفطر is given to. And the view, the khilaf, the dispute is of two views. أحدهما, the first of the two is أن مصرف زكاة الفطر هو مصرف زكاة المال. That the زكاة الفطر, where it's being given to, is the same as that which is given to زكاة المال. The eight. In سورة التوبة, Ayah 60, where Allah says إنما الصدقات للفقراء والمساكين والعاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم وفي الرقاب والغامرين والغارمين وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل. The eight that were mentioned in that verse. This is the view of the jumhur of the ulama, the majority of the scholars, from the Hanafiyya and the Shafi'iyya, and this is well known and documented from the madhab al-Hanabil as well. It's mashhur in the madhab. The second opinion is that no. And zakatul fitri khasatun bil fuqara'i wal masakin. It's specific. It is only for the fuqara and the masakin, the poor and the needy. وَلَا تُصْرَفُ إِلَّا إِلَيْهِمْ. And no one else can be given it except them. This opinion is held by the Malikiyya and the Hanabila ala qawlin. It's a view within the Hanbali madhab, but it's not the common and the well-known view. And this is the view that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah chose. This is the view Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah strengthened. And the reason for that is because لِمُنَاسَبَةِ لِمَشْرُوعَةِ زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ. Because this is what goes with the wisdom of the zakat al-fitr. And this is one of the things the Hanafi madhab contradict themselves in. Because before, the argument was what? That it should be given in money because the wisdom is the poor people are in need. Are you there? But then here they go against the wisdom, which is what? That the zakat al-fitr, the wisdom that it was zakat al-fitr, the wisdom why it was legislated is to help and aid who? The poor Muslims for the day of Eid. So if you take the eight types that are mentioned, then other than the Muslims are in that. That's one reason why they're wrong on that. وَاخْتِصَاصِهَا بِالْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْحَصْرِ. And also, that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام specifically narrowed it down to the فقراء and the مساكين. In the Hadith Abi Dawud narrated in Ibn Majah, من Hadith Ibn Abbas, where the Prophet said, طُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. طُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. It is food for the poor and needy ones. And the ayah in Surah At-Tawbah is referring to the masarif of zakat al-mal. It's talking about zakat al-mal. It's not talking about la sadaqat al-fitri. Not the sadaqat al-fitr. The sadaqat al-fitri has a hadith which is specific for it. This hadith is specific for it. And that is why Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah says, وَلَا يَجُوزُ دَفْعُ زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ إِلَّا لِمَنْ يَسْتَحِقُّ الْكَفَارَةِ وَهُوَ مَنْ يَأْخُذُ لِحَاجَتِهِ لَا فِي الرِّقَابِ وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ وَجَدِيرُ بِالتَّنْبِيهِ. And what is also important that I bring to the attentions is that zakatul fitri is not permissible to give to a harbi. It is not permissible to give to a al-musta'min. And this is by ijma'. That you can't give it to the harbi, the one that's in fight and battle with you. You're also not allowed to give it to the musta'min, the one that's been given aman and safety. As it's also not permissible, that's by consent, that's ijma'. And it's also not permissible to give it to other than a Muslim. It's only allowed for a Muslim. Specific to the Muslims. And you can't give it to the disbelievers. And that second part is according to the Ammatul Fuqaha, the majority of the scholars. Abu Hanifa opposes. Abu Hanifa said that the Zakatul Fitr can be given to other than the Muslim. It can be given to the kafir who is the dhimmi. Dhimmi. He said it's allowed to be given to him. Why has that dispute, how has that dispute arose? And how has it come into place? It is the hadith Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned. The hadith Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala that I just mentioned, which is in Sunnah Abi Dawood, طُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. The masakeen here, or the fuqara, is it مجرد الفقر, or is it الفقر والإسلام معًا? Is it just by being poor, or is it poor and Islam? Which of it is? The Ammatul Fuqaha and the Jumhur, the majority of the scholars, they are saying, it is al-faqr wal-islamu ma'an. It is poverty and poor, the person who is poor, and he's a Muslim, together, simultaneously. And the reason why they say that is because, they say because the context, the an-siyaq hadith ibn Abbas, because the context of the hadith ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, where the Prophet said, وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ, that it's a food for the masakeen, the poor ones. They said that يُفِيدُ بِظَاهِرِهِ, from the apparent, it benefits us. And what we take from it, from the apparent, is that the masakeen that is being referred to here are the masakeen of the Muslims, no one other than that. Because the people who are being spoken to are the Muslims. Are you with me? So, هو المتبادر إلى الذهن. It is what runs to the mind straight away when you say وطعمة للمساكين. The thing that the مساكين that runs to the mind straight away, it is the مساكين of the Muslims. And to then try to divert it from that which comes to the mind first, it requires evidence from the people who try to do that. Even the أصل of the zakatul mal, even the zakatul mal, the أصل for it, and that is مقرر, that you would find, is, and which is منصوص عليه, is that is حديث معاذ بن جبل, that is the Muslims. That's the أصل. Because the Prophet ﷺ, what did he say to them? إِنَّكَ سَتَأْتِي قَوْمَ أَهْلِ كِتَابٍ فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ شَهَادَةَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ فَإِنَّهُمْ أَطَاعُوكَ لِذَلِكَ فَأَخْبِرْهُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ افْتَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ خَمْسَ صَلَوَاتٍ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمٍ وَلَيْلَةٍ فَإِنَّهُمْ أَطَاعُوكَ لِذَلِكَ فَأَخْبِرْهُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ افْتَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ زَكَاةً تُؤْخَذُ مِنْ أَغْنِيَائِهِمْ فَتُرَدُّ إِلَى فُقَرَائِهِمْ. It's taken from the أغنياء, the rich, and it's then given to the فُقَرَائِهِمْ, their فُقَرَاء. Who's فُقَرَاء? The zakat, the ones who are paying, their فُقَرَاء, their own people, their own Muslims. Does that make sense? So that was also the asal of the zakatul mal, let alone zakatul fitr. And that is what is apparent in this issue. As for أَمَّا غَيْرُ الْمُسْلِمِ, as for other than a Muslim, can a person give them a sadaqah? Can a person, other than a Muslim, can a person give sadaqah to other than a Muslim? Can a Muslim, just a sadaqah, normal sadaqah, that's not zakatul fitr, can he go and give a sadaqah? General sadaqah. That is not obligatory. Sadaqah, just he has money, you know, he wants to give sadaqah. Can he go give it to the disbelievers? As it's been transmitted from Hassan al-Basri, أنه قال that he said, ليس لأهل الذمة في شيء من الواجب حق. That Hassan al-Basri said, the أهل الذمة, they have no right in that which is obligatory. Meaning the wajibat, from the zakat and the sadaqat, they have no right in that. ولكن إن شاء الرجل تصدق عليه من غير ذلك. But if a Muslim person wants to give out a normal charity, sadaqah, are you with me? Out of his own, it's not wajib. If he wants to, he said he can. And then that meaning of Hassan al-Basri follows the ayah, تُحْمَلُ الْآيَةِ الَّتِي اسْتَدَلَّ بِهَا الْأَحْحَافِ عَلَى جَوَازِ فِي قَوْلِهِ. It goes exactly hand in hand with the ayah in Surah Al-Mumtahina, ayah 8, which the Ahnaf also use, which is لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. And we will conclude there, inshaAllah ta'ala. وَالْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَإِخْوَانِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ الدِّينِ وَسَلَّمَ تَسْلِيمًا مَزِيدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الدِّينِ.